During an interview with Steve Bannon this week, Republican Congressman Matt Gaetz actually admitted that this so-called FBI whistleblower that Republicans have been trying to hype up, you know, for a week or so now, and nobody seems to care about it, but he admitted that this whistleblower who says that Biden took a $5 million bribe from Ukraine while he was vice president, Gaetz says, yeah, he doesn't actually have any evidence, you know, to back it up. So, oops. And Matt Gaetz said that on there. He didn't add the oops. But here is what Matt Gaetz said. And I found the claims credible, but I want to be very clear about something. Even what's on a 1023 form is an allegation. And the important work ahead is not to reflexively lurch into some sort of legislative procedural posture. It is to track down the bank records. It is to look for these 17 audio recordings that I knew were alleged to have existed several months ago. And so there's going to have to be some very serious work. He's, of course, referring to that form, the one that Marjorie Taylor Green went out there and admitted she copied last week, which actually might be a felony. But all they have is hearsay. All they have is one guy, a paid FBI informant, who says, oh, I'm totally sure that Biden took a $5 million bribe while he was vice president. Wonderful. Come with us or come back to us when you have evidence, Matt. Like, y'all are hyping this thing up in the same way that you criticize the Democrats for hyping up the Steele dossier, and y'all aren't even smart enough to realize you're doing the exact same thing here. I know you guys need any kind of news you can get to distract from what's happening from Donald Trump, but for the love of God, could y'all just come up with some evidence here, please? As I've said repeatedly, if y'all get rid of Biden from office, seriously, you're doing us a favor, the Democrats. Majority of Democrats do not want President Biden to run again. Now, I don't think the guy is corrupt. I don't think he should be impeached. But if he is, I'm not going to lose any sleep, right? Then we can get some really good Democrats entering the 2024 race, and we might end up with a candidate much better than Biden would be. Maybe somebody that's not having to fight against Donald Trump for a majority support. Maybe we can put somebody in there that could easily win that thing without having to get too down and dirty with a, you know, potentially convicted felon at that point. But we'll see. If y'all have the evidence, bring it forward. Again, I don't care. I'm not trying to downplay this investigation. I'm just going on what Republicans are telling us. And right now, as Matt Gaetz made crystal clear, Republicans are telling us they don't have anything. They've told us that with the other investigations into the Biden family taking place in the House. Like, we don't have anything. We have nothing material. We have nothing concrete. Oh, we have hunches. We have guesses. We have hearsay. But none of that is going to hold up in a court of law if you ever want to put Biden behind bars. And don't act like y'all are just now learning about this stuff, Matt. Y'all have been working on this for years. And for the record, it is worth noting that, of course, this information, this FBI whistleblower form, was actually presented to Donald Trump's Justice Department, and they chose to do nothing with it. So you can get mad, you can be, you know, conspiratorial all you want about we're going to take down Biden, but at the end of the day, Trump's own people had this information and didn't think it was worth an investigation. Thanks for watching, everyone, and well, here comes the awkward part at the end of the video where I ask you to like, comment, and share, and subscribe for more content from Ring of Fire. Also, you should consider becoming a member for some exclusive content and perks, including early access videos and exclusive videos. Check out the link in the description.